Hello students, today I am discussing about the RAID, that means redundant arrays of independent disk. It is a technique which makes use of combination of multiple disks instead of a single disk for increased performance, data redundancy or both. First we have to know what is data redundancy. Data redundancy, although taking up extra space, adds to disk reliability. This means in case of disk failure, if the same data is also backed up onto another disk, we can retrieve the data and go on with this operation. On the other hand, if the data is spread across just multiple disks without the RAID technique, the loss of a single disk can affect the entire data. If we discuss about the key evolution points for a RAID system, we can get reliability, availability, performance, and capacity. Reliability means how many disk faults can the system tolerate. In case of availability, what fraction of the total session time is the system in uptime mode? That means how available is the system for actual use. Performance is the response time. How good is the response time? How high is the throughput? That means rate of processing work. Capacity, how much useful capacity is available to the user. RAID is very transparent to the underlying system. This means to the host system. It appears as a single big disk presenting itself as a linear array of blocks. This allows older technologies to be replaced by RAID without making too many changes in the existing mode. These are different RAID labels. RAID 0, 1, RAID 2, RAID 3, RAID 4, RAID 5, and RAID 6. First, we have to why we need RAID. Nowadays, computing speeds double every 3 years. These speeds can't keep up. I/O performance and availability issue. That is why we need RAID. RAID allows us to avoid these issues by parallelism, load balancing, redundancy, availability. I have already discussed. There is two main concept in RAID, that is mirroring, that is keep two copies of data on two separate disks. That gives good error recovery. If some data is lost, get it from the other source. It is very expensive because it requires twice as many disks. Its write performance can be slow because it have to write data in two different spots. Read performance is enhanced because it can read data from files in parallel way. Second concept is striping. Take file data and map it to different disks. Allows for reading data in parallel. RAID level 0. It splits data evenly across two or more disks. RAID 0 is normally used to increase performance. Although it can also be used as a way to create a large logical disk out of two or more physical ones. RAID level 1, it creates an exact copy, that is a mirroring concept. This is useful when read performance is more important than data storage capacity. Write throughput is always slower because every drive must be updated on each entry. RAID level 2, it stripes data at bit level and uses Hamming code for error correction. All disks participate in the execution of every input-output. The spindles of individual disks are synchronized so that each disk head in the same position on each disk at any time. RAID 2 is random deployed because cost to implement are usually prohibitive and gives poor performance with some disk input-output operations. RAID level 3, it stripes data at byte level with dedicated parity bit. All disks are synchronized such that each bit is on different drive. RAID 3 is not commonly used. All disks can access in parallel way. RAID level 4, it stripes data at block level with dedicated parity bit. It is very rarely used in practice. NetApp is the enterprise that previously used this RAID. This approach allows multiple writes to be done, but that makes performance slower. RAID level 5, it stripes data at block level with distributed parity. Parity information is distributed among the drives. Upon failure of a single drive, subsequent reads can be calculated, so no data is lost. It requires minimum 3 disks. RAID level 6. It stripes data at block level with double distributed parity. Double parity provides fault tolerance up to 2 drives. Performance varies depending on how it is implemented. This is the differences between R0, that means RAID 0 to RAID 6. Here we can see that in case of RAID 0, 2 drives are minimum required, R1 for 2, R2 for 3, R3 for 3, R4, 3 minimum drives are required. In case of R6, minimum number of drives are required are 4. Fault tolerance, read performance is high in all the cases, but write performance is low for R3, R4, R5 and R6. And in case of R1, R2, it is medium, and for R0, it is high. Right? Thank you, students.